Welcome, dear children, to the session. For 2 minutes, I will wait for others to join, and then we will start with the recapitulations of the lesson which we have done. And as promised, today I am going to tell you about still characterization. I hope I am audible. So very good evening to everyone here. Welcome back to the session. Please inform if I'm audible. I'm waiting for your reply, then we will start the class. Oh, very good. Thank you. Just 1 minute more and then we are going to start with the revision. Recapitulation, what we have discussed in the last two classes related to the last lesson. Hope you are doing good. So now I think it's quite, we have waited for enough time and everybody knows at 4 we are going to begin. So, first of all, we are going to recapitulate what we have done in the previous classes. Right? So, the last lesson by Alfonso Durde. Now, see, once again, I'm revising. In the first paragraph, we come to know that this I character, who is actually friends, the student of M. Hamel, the French teacher. He was unwilling to go to school. Why? Because he was very late that day to school that day. He has not learnt his lessons on participles and he was afraid. That means afraid of scolding by M. Hamel, who was a strict teacher. So instead of going to school, he wished to run away and spend his day out of doors. Why? Because it was warm and bright day. Also, he wished to listen to birds chirping and also wished to see the Prussian soldiers drilling. And yes, obviously, all these things were more interesting, more tempting than the dry rules of participants. But he was strong enough to resist and he hurried off to school. Okay, so this was in the first paragraph. In the second paragraph, the scene at town hall was explained. Where town hall was famous or known place because of the bulletin board. And that time, the bulletin board used to be the source of news for everybody. Okay. And he says that since last 2 years, they were receiving bad news from this notice board. That day, there was again a crowd at the notice board, near the notice board, bulletin board. And what was the crowd for? There must be some news. But because France was getting late, he didn't get near to the board and was hurrying off towards his school. When a blacksmith named Watcher, he interrupted and he said to him, "Don't go fast, don't go so fast, Bob. You will get to your school in plenty of time." And we have already discussed that this statement is actually an ironical statement. Because already there was an order from Berlin that next day onwards there will be no French teaching. Not only no French teaching, but all French teachers were ordered to leave the country so that they don't have any any option to learn French. Then, after reaching to school, friends noticed that day was not a normal day, not a usual school. Why? Because usually, generally, every day, what was there? There used to be a great noise, the noise of opening and closing of desks, the lessons repeated in unison, fine, and also the rapping on the table. So she used to, noise was of three things. Number one, opening and closing of desks, lessons repeated in unison, and also the great ruler of teacher rapping on the table. But that day it was perfectly calm, like a Sunday morning when everybody is relaxed, nobody's in mood to do anything. And also he found that M. Hamel was patient that day. Patient means like he was not angry, though he was late, but very gently he spoke, saying, "Go to your place, friends, little friends, we were beginning without you." After this second change, means there was quite, everything was calm. Then number two, M. Hamel was not angry for him being late. And also he saw that M. Hamel was wearing a beautiful green coat, his frilled shirt, and also embroidered little black silk cap. And this was special dress for him. Why? Because he used to wear this special dress only on inspection and prize days. So this was the third change. Fourth change, he saw that the old villagers were sitting on the back seat of the class, the back benches of the class. Generally, those back benches remain empty. Okay, so these were the changes that day. Then when Mr. Ham Hamel started the lesson, he informed that the order from the Berlin. What was it? Was the order that there will be no German teaching in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine from the next day, and teacher has also to leave, and next day French teacher will be there to teach them French. These words were thunderclap, a shock to France. And then discovery that there will be no teaching of French from the next day, there was a change in him. What was the change? Number one, he was sorry for not listening his lessons. Number two, he was sorry for seeking for bird's egg and wasting his time in seeking for bird's egg and going sliding on SATs. So first change was that he was sorry all of a sudden for all how he has wasted his time and has not utilized his time in learning. Second change was that his attitude towards his books changed. Earlier, his books, which used to be a nuisance and heavy to carry for him, now all of a sudden he started feeling that his books are his old friends, and he didn't wish to give his books up. Okay. Third change. First was about his attitude. He was sorry. Second was his attitude towards books, and third was his attitude towards M. Hamel. So his attitude towards M. Hamel also changed. He didn't like M. Hamel because he was very cranky, very strict teacher. But that day, knowing that he won't be able to meet M. Hamel again, he forgot everything about him, about his ruler, about his strictness, and just the idea that he won't be able to see M. Hamel again made him sad. And then he come to know that why M. Hamel was wearing his Sunday clothes. This question is again very important for an exam. I told you earlier that why the bank benches of the class were occupied by the villagers. So number one, like friends, they were sorry for neglecting their language, not learning it. Number two, they were thanking their master, M. Hamel, for 40 years of faithful service. And next is that they were showing respect for their country. Next is that while I was thinking Then MML started his class, and one by one, he started what we say that he started his reading class first, then he started his grammar, then he took the lesson on writing, and then history. Meanwhile, when Franz couldn't read his lesson, he said to MML that MML said to him that he will not scold him. And then he started thinking about who is responsible for not learning French in Alsace district. And then he find out, first of all, he blamed students for it. Not friends, but all the students, all the French people who have neglected their lessons and have postponed their learning till next day. Okay. Number two, he blamed the parents, who were more anxious in sending their children to work than to make them study in the school. And the third, he blamed himself for neglecting his duties as a teacher, involving students in some other work when the class is going on, or giving them a holiday when he wished to go on fishing. So one man started taking lesson. He said that French is the most beautiful language in the world, most logical, reflects a little of his chauvinism, but also his language, his patriotism and love for language. And then we also come to know about the what we say, yes, his mental conditions. Mentally, he was not very what we say, alert, or you can say mentally he was torn. His emotions were torn. Why? Because he has lived at that place for 40 years, tended everything, the garden, the trees, the vines, and now all of a sudden he has to leave the place and go. So you can understand how broken his heart was. He was making his drawings. Now we come to know how we ended his lesson. That is very important. He took a piece of chalk, and with all his courage, all his strength, he wrote on the board as large as he could, Vive la France. Okay? And he stopped and leaned his head against the wall, and without a word, he made the gesture, school dismissed. He was so much, his emotions were so brimming, that he couldn't speak even. He was choked in his throat. So instead of speaking anything, he wrote on the board, Vive la France. Dear children, we are done with the recapitulation once more. And now I don't think that you are going to forget the lesson anytime. One thing more which I wish to discuss with you is the title of this story, The Last Lesson, which is apt. The title means justification, is justifies, because it is about the last lesson of French. And M. Hamel has done justice to it. Dear children, as promised, I'm going to start with stale characterization. Okay, so what is this stale characterization? And I wonder why I wish you to learn this stale characterization. Dear children, this is very, very important. I have learned this technique recently. And you will find that you will not get stuck up. In CBSE, indirectly you get the questions on characterization in 6 marks. So how you can write that indirect characterization in your 6 marks, that's very important, because in 6 marks questions, 3 marks are for content and 3 marks are for your expression, which includes coherence and connectivity and how you are arranging your ideas. So if you know a stale characterization technique, it will be very, very easy for you to write any character sketch. So let's start with it. So dear children, as I told you, there are two types of characterization. One is direct characterization and the other is indirect characterization. In direct characterization, we actually the author, he tells us everything. Means we need not to think over it or infer the meanings or infer what the character is or to think over it. We know it directly from the text what the character is. For example, see here, the patient boy and quiet girl were both well-mannered and did not disobey their mother. So this is the line taken from some text, and it clearly tells that the boy was patient and the girl was quiet, and both of them were well-mannered, and they both of them never disobeyed their mother. So directly you come to know about the character. You need not to think much over it. It is very much clear from the text itself. Yes, so now this is our set of learning, indirect characterization. Dear children, as indirect characterization, I told you that you are not told directly by the author about the character traits. And you have to find it on your own. Yes, if a character is behaving in this manner, then yes, this character is possessing this personality trait. For example, William addresses Margaret with attitude when he states, "What are you looking at?" So explanation, even though the author doesn't say William is rude, he's not saying William is rude, but he is quoting his dialogue, "What are you looking at?" Which is, not very friendly. And it infers that, you can infer easily that that William, this character who is saying this statement, is actually rude. Well, oh, so before I move forward, let us see what steal is. Steal means taking away the things of someone else. Steal is actually an acronym which means, S stands for speech. So we can infer what a character it is. This is the easiest thing to know by seeing that how the characters speak. If we could make out what character speaks, it gives an insight into their personality. Fine. So we can look at the slang, the accent, the tone, which we have to, while in reading this text, we have to imagine. And this tells about his personality. T in steel stands for thoughts. Means how the character is thinking and feeling. It reveals about his character. Third is effect on others. Fine. So whatever the action that character is taking, what are the effects on the other characters in the story? And then comes actions. So it reveals a lot about the character. Why? Because whatever he does, you can easily say, yes, this is good or bad. And the last L in steel stands for looks. This is very simple. How the character looks like, what is the age, how he dress himself up, what type of facial expression he wear always, and many things. Now we will see the steel characteristics from by seeing the example from some different character, and then we will discuss about M. Hamel. Now see here, a character speaks, it talks about a speech in S, steel. So look at how a character speaks to determine what he or she might be like. See this boy, you can see the expression also. Hey Grease, we are gonna go do you a favor, Greaser. We are gonna cut all that long greasy hair off. The very tone is not good. It's rude. So yes, from this we can make out that this character is an aggressive and rude character. Now comes to the thought. So look at what thoughts a character has to learn more about him or her. See, this circle sort of shows this man, this boy is thinking, and you can see the expression also sad. Me and Daddy just didn't dig each other. I never could please him. So it's very clear that this character, he thinks that his name is Pony Boy, and the character he is talking about, Derry, we have just seen that he was rude. Because of his language, because of his tone, he thinks that he doesn't care about him. So now effect on others. So look how the characters react to one another to determine more about them. So what is the reaction or action of or the effect of their actions on others? Like for example, see this character. I was smarting and aching and my chest was sore. And I was so nervous, my hands were shaking, and I wanted to start bawling, but you just don't say that to Derry. So in this, it is clear that this character, Derry, his name, he is actually a shy character. He fails to express his feelings. Okay, so he fails to express his feelings, and that's why it makes Pony, the character in the previous slide you have seen, think that he doesn't think about him. Okay, so are you getting? So that was the effect on him. Are you getting? So this the shyness of this character is taken as uncaring attitude by some other character. Though he was not like that, he was actually an intimate character. So now action. This is very important. It's very well said that action speaks more than words. So even if you are having sugar coated tongue, but when your actions are just disapproving it, you are not that good. So the actions taken by a character in the story tells more about the personality of that character. See here the dialogue. He pulled out a handkerchief with the end of it with his tongue and pressed it gently the side of my head. It shows that he didn't say anything. Maybe the character was hurt, okay, over on the head, and this boy, he didn't say anything. It just took out the handkerchief and wet it with his tongue and pressed gently. So his expression is speaking more about him, and what his action has a positive effect on the person who is receiving his kind action, receiver of his kind act. Okay, so all the things are interconnected. See, so look also tells much about the character. See this statement? I automatically hitched my thumbs in my jeans and slouched, wondering if I could get away if I made a run for it. So it clearly shows that this character is nervous and not confident. And that's why he is hitching his thumbs in his jeans. And he's wondering also to run away, run for it. So wondering if I could get away, and he want to get away from there. So it shows that this character is not confident enough. Fine, so now we know what STEEL stands for. So STEEL, S stands for speech, T for thoughts, E for effect on others, A for actions, and L for looks. Now we are going to discuss it with the characters of M. Hamel, and I will tell you how to write the characterization using STEEL. Okay. So as we have seen that five elements of characterization can be explained with acronym STEEL. And we already know what STEEL stands for. S for speech or speak, what he speaks. Thoughts, effects on others, actions and looks. Okay. So one by one, we are going to identify it in the character of M. Hamel. I wish you to have a pen or a pencil or a copy to write on a notebook. If you don't have, doesn't matter. You listen and read. You can see to this, the last part of the video once again. And learn how to write the character sketch. Because if you could write the character sketch of M. Hamel using STEEL, you can write any character sketch. And this is very, very important questions. Later on in every story, there is going to be one important character. So if you know one or two, not even one, two sometimes. So if you know how to write a character sketch, you can easily do justice with the question. Okay, so let's come back. Speak. So what the speech? So let us, we are doing character sketch of M. Hamel. So let's see what M. Hamel, and if I miss some point, I want to drop the message in the drop box, comment box. Okay, I'm listening to you. So you please write if you think yes, some points I am missing. So see M. Hamel character. What he speaks? From the chapter, we find out what he speaks. He speaks about his language. Remember? When he says that the French is the most beautiful, clearest, and let me find out the sentence. Yes, here. Most beautiful language in the world, the clearest and the most logical. So this, what he said, it clearly reflects that he is a true patriot. He loves his language. And also because he's a teacher of French, so you can say he is a good French teacher. The teacher who loves his subject is a good teacher. Okay. So he speaks that he tells about the beauty of French language reflects three things. Number one, his patriotic nature. Number two, that he is a good teacher. Number three, it also shows his love for the country. Then what he says, but at the end of the chapter, he couldn't say, but he could only write. Because he was brimming with emotion. What he write? Vive la France, long live France. So we can also say that this is a speech, okay? So it again shows his patriotism and also his positive attitude that he wish good luck to his country, okay? And also he wished his students to have that love for the language and the country, not to lose that under the impact of slavery, okay? I was looking for some ideas from you, but couldn't. Thoughts. Now, what thought? This is very tricky for Hamel, because everywhere we could see that he is doing his actions. We could see his actions. But dear children, here you see his thoughts, you can say, when he reflects on who are responsible for not learning French. At that time, he is actually giving voice to his thoughts. Okay? So his thoughts were that he was himself even responsible for not learning French by the French people. Fine, because he has engaged his student in some other work when the class was going on, or he has given the students a holiday. Okay, so his thoughts, not only this is the one example of thought. The second example of thought I would like to, because I don't think that you will be easily finding it. When the students were busy in writing, and what he was doing, he was sitting motionless, okay, gazing. You cannot gaze at anything without thinking. He wanted to fix in his mind everything he looked in that little schoolroom, and outside that schoolroom. So what his thoughts were, maybe he was thinking that what he is going to do after going from that place, because he is not going to have any job. Maybe, not sure. He has to leave everything all of a sudden. For 40 years he has lived there. He was having painful thoughts of leaving that place all of a sudden. Okay? Then comes effects. What were the effects of his action on him? Effects of his action on the other people. So we see that his effects were of his actions were very positive on others. How? They were taking their lessons seriously. They learned how important their language is. They also learned that yes, that language is the key to prison. Right? And also, the class ended with a positive note. So this was having a good effect on them. And the last is their action. Second last is the actions. So what action he has taken? He has honored his last lesson by wearing a special dress. He well planned his lesson. He didn't hurry it up, though he knew that it was his last lesson, but still he did perfect justice with his class. He took all the lessons till the end of the school and also ended the class with a positive note. How he looks? So generally he looked to be very strict, but that day he was looking patient. He looked tall. The very last line, very important. He looked tall. Okay. He says he has never looked so tall. Here Tolls talks about his stature, that how great a person he was. Okay. So we have discussed all the 5 points of steel characterization, but this will not help you out perfectly. You cannot make this table in exam and write your answer. What you are supposed to do, you have to transfer these points into a paragraph. So this is going to be your, what we say, the exercise for homework. And dear children, because our this lesson and all the learning objectives of the last lesson is over, are over now. We know all the learning objectives we have done. We are done with it. So tomorrow we will start with the poem My Mother at 66, and it will not take more than one period. And after that, the next day, I am going to take the supplementary reader story, the third level. Dear children, this is your homework, that number one, you are going to write the character sketch using steel in a paragraph, not in the points, in a paragraph. because that is the requirement of your CBSE exam. And the second, you are going to read the story from Vistas, the third level. So these are your two homeworks. Okay, so thank you for joining today. The homework. Your homework I'm writing. Because if you don't read third level, you won't be able to understand. It is supplementary reader. And the second is, number two, reading of the third level. And tomorrow I am going to teach you the poem for the first poem of the book Flamingo, the last lesson. So please do your homework. Thank you. And tomorrow lesson is so tomorrow we are going to be there with. Fine. Thank you. Bye. See you tomorrow. Thanks.